I feel as if I just can't reach him. Perhaps I can persuade him to go for a walk with me this afternoon.
If anyone can persuade Victor, it's you. There you are. Why not join me for a ride in the country after dinner, like we used to?
Not tonight. I have work to do.
It seems to me you've been working much too hard and neglecting other more important things. The secrets of the universe can certainly wait until tomorrow, and Elizabeth seems rather concerned for you.
But how can I dare feel such comfort when tragedy strikes all those around me? I couldn't save them. My poor baby brother William and dear Justine. Your Justine.
I too. Grief for William and Justine more than you know, but neither of us could have done anything, could we?
No.
Tragedy strikes home in some day. We are helpless to keep it away. But all people must go on living, sharing and giving while still remembering. Life must go on, dear Victor, life must go on. You have so much more to give. Life must go on, my friend, life must go on, life must go on. Don't give up hope while you still yet live. Let your spirits rise and think ahead of future joys, not of sorrow. Forget your fears and dry your tears. Think of tomorrow. You still have much to be thankful for. You still have love, the one you adore. You still have your strength and your health, and even your wealth, so don't close the door. We can't bring back those who have died, even though for years people tried. All we can do is get on with our lives. The living still need you, not least your chosen bride, Elizabeth. Let us go on, dear Victor, don't let the dark days pass to cloud your head. Let us go on, my friend, let us go on, let us go on. We are still living, we are not the dead. Don't let the ghosts and demons get into your head. Don't look back. Don't look back. Just look ahead.
You have your whole life with Elizabeth ahead of you.
Yes.
Well, are you coming to dinner?
I'll be just...
formed like mine, the stature straight and tall. my soul. The dream had recurred, the dream I had when my life was new. That was not a dream, was it? You abandoned me too.
I did. I was terrified. When I returned to the lab next morning, you were already gone.
When the breeze that was blowing calmed, I saw the image of trees in the pond. I walked over to the water's edge, looking down, saw my own image. What a hideous thing was I!
I tried to make you beautiful, I tried to make you perfect, better than myself.
I knew that while they ran in horror, who could not have been afraid of such a dreadful monster? For death I nearly prayed.
What have I done?
Late that night I sought shelter here and replaced the sheets with clothes to wear, and this cloak I found wrapped it round to mask from the world my image.
If only I had waited in the lab.
Everyone still reacted with alarm, turned away, or tried to do me harm. I knew I must travel on to find another creature of my kind.
I looked for you. For days in the surrounding areas, I eventually assumed that you did not survive. I found no trace of you.
In the clearing of the forest came I upon a small house. Dared not approach during daylight, lest we see the chase away. But in the evening I wandered toward the window, saw inside a young man, a girl, and a blind man with hair of gray. I wanted to know of the lives of men and their plight, so I watched them from under the cloak of night, shielded by the forest during daylight. Through the window I could see them smiling, laughing, sometimes crying together in their home. From the outside I was looking inward, always on the outside and always on my own. You made me a body more durable than your own, thus I could last through the long winter's cold alone, dreaming of being inside of them, enduring the harsh weather. I cried when the old man played sweet music on guitar, laughed when the lad tried to dance dressed up as the Tsar, hid as they left for town together. I listened at the window, absorbing every word. I soon began to understand the sounds uttered round the table, and tales from a book called the Bible, which speaks of the God who created the world. It soon became clear how this God had created men apart and together, to talk and walk hand in hand. God created Adam and Eve together. God be my God too, I began to pray then. Maybe someday I can hope to find my mate. I won't have to be alone forever. When I could not be discovered, I'd reach inside the window and gently lift the volume from which they had read the moment prior. And learned about mankind, his history, his fire, his dreams and aspirations. Yet to what could I aspire? I then read the words in the book I found in my coat. Are they your words, Victor? Yes, they're the words you wrote. Experimental diary of Victor Frankenstein, aligning the tale of my horrid creation. I don't share a god, a race, or a nation. Man's creator guides him, my fled from me in disgust.
Went into town. Then I approached the blind man. kind to me and fed me. We talked. For the first time, I had a companion. I lent him my vision and read to him. But then his children returned without warning. I could see their horror. The maiden screamed. The young man beat me. I could have torn him limb from limb, but I refrained. Cursed creator, why did I live? Why did I live?
For mercy's sake,
I shut out. Again, determined to find you again, my creature. I needed assistance in finding your place of residence. Then came I upon a young boy.
William.
I thought his bias might not yet be formed, but still, I approached him carefully. But he reacted like the rest. Paled and screaming with fright, he called for his nanny. Justine! Justine! He cried. I cupped my hand over his face to silence him for fear of being discovered, and soon he ceased to struggle. When all was still, I lifted my hand from the child's face to speak with him. But his small, limp body slipped down beside me onto the ground.
Oh!
You cannot know the pain I felt upon seeing William's body lifeless beside me, or the subsequent torment I felt upon discovering he was your beloved brother. I had not known death before, only unfortunate life. Death is colder and more lonely than my own miserable existence. I watched the events that later transpired unobserved. The girl was arrested and brought to trial, but I knew there could be no witness against her. Justice. Justice shalt thou pursue, the Bible says. Certainly she would be acquitted. But she was hanged. Mankind showed no justice or compassion. Even for one so fair to look upon as Justine, what could I expect of them? I cannot expect forgiveness, but you are my creator. I am your responsibility. You, who created me for your own gratification, then left me to face the miserable torment of your race alone. I was your dream. I am your proof. Who am I? What am I? I'm asking you. Why? Tell me why. Why have you created me? Why? Tell me why. Why have you created me? You commanded collapse of thunder. Lightning that ignited me from the depths of eternal slumber. Won't you do what's right?
Want to resist?
I don't compel.
Things are amiss.
I know we do well.
Why should I live like this? A father to a child, a
wife.
Please,
wife.
Go! Please go away! I can't allow you to stay here.
Why?
Oh no!
Why?
Please go! Run where you can, far from me, and disappear.
Now listen to me.
You're the only one.
Possible task is all that I ask of you.
Just leave me alone! Get out! must not let her see you!
Without love.